for joining us. The fabulous Chris Barth is our guest host this morning. You've been on our screens for so long. I just feel like, can we call you Barthy? Is that cool?
It's weird when people don't. And okay. The only person, my name's actually Christine.
Oh.
But there's like,
when
literally
you're in trouble, though, I
one.
Imagine.
Yes, when yeah. I'm Maureen. My mum is the only person that calls me Christine, and it's only when I'm in strife. So it's Christine! So it's either Chris or Barthy or whatever other names. There are a million nicknames for me. So, yeah.
Well, I'm going with Barthy. Yeah. And there is a serious side as to why Barthy is here today. Take a look.
I want to tell you a story about a man named Don.
He's my soulmate. He's my friend. He's my husband. I just love him.
Don had a massive stroke. One more thing I want to tell you. Don is my dad.
Aww. I still can't watch this.
Yeah. How is your beautiful dad?
Look, you know what? Dad's learnt to live with the stroke. He had the stroke in 2009. He's half paralysed down his right side. He had to learn to swallow again. That took about 12 months.
Gosh.
He had to learn to walk again. He can walk with a quad stick. I mean, you can see Dad there. He's got a splint on his leg. Because his right arm, which was the arm that he used, Dad was right-handed, is so badly paralysed, it just hangs like a piece of meat. So to protect his shoulder girdle, he has to wear a sling. And it thrust us into a whole range of issues that I think we just never really considered.
How old was he when he had the stroke?
Well, Dad was actually quite young. You know, he was young, he was fit, he was 67. He was vibrant, he was a fit man, he didn't smoke, he wasn't overweight, he didn't have a lot of the indicators that are common for stroke. But it was strange for me. I think for, you know, by that stage I'd been reading news for about 25 years in various guises as a journalist, and I'd heard a lot about breast cancer and prostate cancer and dementia, thanks to people like you. Didn't know much about stroke, and started reading the stats and was incredulous. You know, they're amazing. This is how you can spot a stroke, which is really important information. It's stroke week right now. Knowing what to do if someone's having a stroke is important. This is the FAST system. So you look at their face, has it drooped a little bit? You look at their arms, can they raise their arms? Is their speech slurred? Has their mouth drooped? And the most important thing is time. Because if you can assess it and get people to hospital within 12 hours, if people have had a clot stroke, which is the most common kind of stroke, we have this fabulous clot-busting medication that can sometimes undo the effects of the stroke entirely, but certainly mitigate the effects. You need to be assessed at hospital for it. It's very, very important that you're assessed properly, because it basically thins your blood and dissipates the stroke. The really annoying thing is that we have this marvellous drug that was helped be invented by Australian scientists, but in 2013, only 12% of people who presented at hospital with a clot stroke who were eligible actually had the treatment. Now, that's an indictment on what's happening with stroke in this country. Our stroke services are going backwards at a rate of knots, and one in six Australians will have a stroke. There is one every 10 minutes in Australia.
Goodness. And is it right, more women than men?
No, it's pretty much spread across the board, but people tend to think either that it's an old man's disease, and it's not. It affects babies, teenagers, people who are still trying to, you know, support their families in their 30s. You can imagine the knock-on effect of that sort of financial strain. Old people, young people. The thing that probably enraged me most is that we have never had a federally funded awareness campaign for stroke, and notionally 80% of strokes are preventable. The majority of strokes are preventable. So we need to do for stroke what has been done so fabulously for breast cancer in this country. Stroke kills more women than breast cancer does. Substantially more women than breast cancer does. I don't want to have a disease off, but I would love to raise awareness for stroke in the way that we've raised awareness about breast cancer, prostate cancer, you know, all of those terrible things. And, you know, to a degree, stroke is a genetic lottery, but it's not like the lottery that cancer is.
Well, thankfully, the National Stroke Foundation has an ambassador, an eloquent and passionate ambassador like you, Chris Barth, and you are going to do... This. You've got a challenge for us.
I put in a little challenge, because one of the side effects from stroke is paralysis, and part of dealing with stroke is rehab, and it's pretty bloody hard to get in Australia. There are more than 450,000 people in Australia who have survived stroke who don't have rehab. and it's crucial. So I brought in something for you guys.
Okay.
I want you to use your non-preferred hand. So I think you're all right-handed.
Yes.
So that means your left hands.
So we open it up?
Yep, open it up. Now, these are basic
tasks. Is it food?
There's a bit of food for you, Jess, because I know you like food. Sarah, I want you to write with your left hand. Now, this is something that stroke survivors go through every day. Joe, you are going to use one hand, brush your teeth, butter some toast. Mm. Ida, you're going to cut a piece of fruit.
Don't even brush
Please
my teeth
cut
with
yourself.
Two hands.
Also, I can't use this. You can't use your right hand at all.
No. I'm going to take the knife out. Probably it's specific.
No. Goodness me. And I mean, and Barty, you have done. Let me just sing your praises for a moment. Incredible work. You're a tireless campaigner for raising awareness for stroke. You are. You're amazing.
I can't concentrate, Jess. Have you seen Joe?
I'm doing my best.
It's hard. Geez.
Dad's mouth's half paralysed. He can't do that. Mm. Right. He can't use his mouth. Mm.
Okay.
So the other thing that's forgotten in all these stats is the impost on carers.
Yeah.
You know, I know we talk about carers and people go, oh, yeah. Mm. But what my mother does for my father is extraordinary, and all carers out there. Yeah. And carers is a whole other issue. Mm. You know? So imagine,
they don't get the support they need.
If we could prevent even 30% of strokes, we would save the health system so much money and save people from this sort of... Oh, well done, Ida.
Not a big hit, but I did it.
But yeah, it's Stroke Week, so please spread the word. Check out the Stroke Foundation's website. They're doing a fantastic job. Yep. And all I'm going to say to the incumbent Prime Minister is, Mr Turnbull, stroke was identified as a national health priority in 1996. Now, if it was a national health priority in 1996, Mr Turnbull, it is a national emergency now. Mm. So please consider starting with an awareness campaign, and then we'll fix the health services from there. Yeah.